In this video, we will study about message passing in Rust and how Rust achieves that using channel. So first, what is message passing? Message passing is a popular approach which ensures safe concurrency and where threads are communicating with each other by sending messages which contain some data. And one major tool that Rust has for accomplishing this message sending concurrency is the channel. So you can think of channel and you can relate to the channels in programming with a channel in real life, where you can think of a channel of water, for example, a stream or a river. So water flows from upstream to downstream. So if this is the river and this is the upstream and this is downstream. So if you place a paper boat here, anywhere in the upstream, it will flow to the downstream and it will reach the end of the downstream. Or you can put any other floating object as well, which floats in the water. So everything will flow downstream. Similarly, in the programming also, we have a channel. So we have a transmitter which sends data. So let's say T is a transmitter, then it will send data and the receiver will receive data. And this is the channel. So data flows from transmitter to receiver in this direction. And if any of this end is closed, if either transmitter has dropped or receiver has dropped, because there needs to be two ends to a channel, otherwise it's closed. In this case, we had just one transmitter or one sender or one producer, we call it with different names, and one receiver. But it can be expanded. We can have multiple worker threads. So let's say this is one thread, T1, and this is done in other thread, T2, and they are communicating via this channel by message passing. But you can think of another scenario where there are some worker threads, W1, W2, W3, W4. So they are doing some work, they are doing some calculations on some different parts of the data, and when they are done with their work, they send the data to another thread, one common aggregator thread, which will combine the result of all of these worker threads. So this is another thread, TR. So in this case, we have multiple transmitters, but one receiver. So multiple producers and single consumer. So one thread generates the data, other receives the data, and we will exactly see this example in a program where we will create one thread that will generate values and send that value down a channel, and we will create another thread that will receive the values, and we will also print the values that we received. So how can we create a channel in Rust? So we use this function channel, and you see this MPSC namespace. So this channel function is in MPSC, and MPSC stands exactly for this MP and SC, that is multiple producers, single consumer. So let's write the example. So first we need to use MPSC. Also, we will be using thread, so we will use this std thread, and now we will create our channel. So this returns a tuple where the first part is transmitter and the second part is receiver. So we will denote our transmitter with TX and receiver with RX. So if you are confused what is the order MPSC, you can think, you can remember the first letter M, and then you think that M stands for multiple. And what is multiple? Producer is multiple and consumer is single. So you can easily figure out MPSC while writing code if you don't have an intelligent IDE like this one. Then we will spawn a thread. And we will move the transmitter into the closure that we'll be creating inside the thread. So we will move the transmitter to it. So the spawn thread will now own the transmitter. And the spawn thread, in fact, needs to own the transmitting end of the channel in order to be able to send messages through the channel. And now let's complete the code. Let's create a value. So this is a producer, so it will produce some value. So the produced value is a string, a very simple data. And this is hello in this case. And then we will send this data once produced. So the way to send is using send function. And here we will put the value that we want to send. And also we are calling unwrap here. So if there is some error, we will panic. But in some real application, we can handle it properly. But in this case, we are just calling unwrap. So we have sent the data, but there should be a receiver. So we have a receiver here, Rx. So Rx will receive a value and the receive function will return a result. And we will capture that into a variable received. And again, we will call unwrap so that it panics in case of error. And now let's print what is the value that is received by the receiver. So let's run it. So we see that the received value is hello, which is exactly what the transmitter had sent. So this receiver has two functions. One is recv that we called here, which blocks the main thread's execution and wait until a value is sent down the channel. But there is another function as well that is available. So let's comment it out and call that one. And that is called tryRecv. So RECV stands for receive. So the difference with this receive and try receive is that the try receive doesn't block, but immediately returns a result. And if the result is not available, a value is not available, it will throw an error. So in this case, there is a high chance that it will panic and throw an error. So let's see it. So you see that as expected, we see that result unwrap on err value empty. So value is not yet available at this receiver end and it throws an error. But this recv blocks the main thread. So in this case, there is no error. So once you are comfortable with this single producer and single consumer, you can expand it to multiple producer and single consumers. And you can think of this as a very similar to a chat application where somebody is sending a message and somebody else is receiving a message. So you can use this same paradigm while creating a chat application.